Hello? Yes, operator? Hedda Hopper returning my call? Good, put her on. Hello, Hedda. Wendell. Wendell who? Niles. Oliver Wendell Niles. Say, look, Hedda, can you be at the Jotham Down store in 5 minutes? Why? Because we're throwing a big surprise party for Lum and Abner. Lum and Abner start their new half-hour show for Frigidaire next Sunday at... Who all's coming? Well, you, I hope. Red Skelton, Margaret Whiting, the Modern Airs, Felix Mills and his orchestra, and I placed a call to Bob Hope in New York. Collect, that is. And I understand that one of the Crosbys will be here. Which one, Hedda? Well, Brother Everett wouldn't commit himself. He said he'd send us a Crosby, but I don't know whether it'll be Bing, Bob, Dixie, or Lindsay. You say you'll be right over, Hedda. Oh, great. I gotta run now. We're going on the air. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Jotham Down store and to our coast-to-coast surprise party for Lum and Abner. Next Sunday, there's a new sign over the Jotham Down store, Frigidaire. And tonight, over CBS, show business turns out to turn in a half hour of music and laughs in honor of the Jotham Down store's grand opening and to pay tribute to one of radio's favorite comedy teams, Lum and Abner. It's a gay, exciting night here at the Jotham Down store, every bit as dazzling as a Hollywood world premiere. Out front, dozens of giant searchlights are sweeping the sky. And, brother, with this smog, the sky should be swept. Right now, I'm pushing my way through the crowd. Excuse me, madam. In order that I can bring our microphone, some of these wonderful people that are on hand for this big Lum and Abner surprise party. Hedda Hopper just walked in. Red Skelton's coming over soon, and... Well, well, and well, look what Brother Everett sent us. Folks, it's Bob Crosby. Say, how's everything over Club 15, Robert?
Well, if I answer that question correctly, do I win a Frigidaire?
No, but we'll be happy to sell you one.
Well, you realize, of course, that I make all my payments in Campbell's soups.
Really? Chicken gumbo or mock turtle?
Well, this week they're paying me clam chowder. You'll take clam chowder and you're going to like it.
Like it? Man, love that soup. Incidentally, Bob, one more question. How come all you Crosbys sing? Don't any of you write songs?
Are you kidding? Right now, I'm plugging a little gem that I knocked out during Club 15 rehearsal last Tuesday. You care to hear?
Well,
Well, thank you, Wendell.
Yes.
Mrs. Harp and our arpeggio, if you please. To the contents of this can, you add one can of cold water, heat to boiling point, and then you serve.
Thank you very much, Bob, but
well,
unfortunately...
I ain't quite finished yet.
I got news for you. You are. No kidding, Bob. What have you got tucked away in your larynx for our Lum and Abner surprise party tonight?
Well, I lugged over a tune that's mighty popular around Club 15 and around the nation. If Felix Mills over there can scrape up a little downbeat, I'll struggle through it.
Felix, see what you have there for Brother Crosby.
You were only fooling, but I was falling in love. It's a story as old as Adam and Eve. I was making love, but you were making believe. You lied to me with kisses.
You lied to him.
I've tried to stop dreaming of, but you were only fooling me while I was falling in love.
You were only fooling, but I was falling in love.
It's a story as old as Adam and Eve.
I was making love, but you were making believe.
You lied to me with your kisses, that I've tried to stop dreaming of, but you were only fooling me while I was falling in love.
simply terrific. I'll headline tomorrow's column with this item. Hopper discovers sensational new baritone.
Here she is, friends, actress, columnist, and number one on your hat parade, Hedda Hopper. Hedda, I hate to throw you a curve, but the sensational new baritone you referred to is Bob Crosby. He's been singing for years, and you did not discover him.
Please, Mr. Niles, I am a columnist. I have no time for facts.
Well, don't you mind Niles, Hedda. Anytime you want to discover me, you go right ahead and discover.
I was only kidding, of course. But, Bob, there's one thing I'm terribly serious about.
Yeah, what's that?
Theme songs.
Well, are you for them or are you against them?
Well, my complaint is this. Everybody in the radio has a theme song. You have a theme song. Yeah. Brother Bing has a theme song. Lum and Abner have a theme song. But do people in other lines of work have theme songs? No. And I say that something ought to be done about it. I say that every occupation should have its own theme song.
Well, you mean like dentists and barbers and lawyers?
I mean everybody. Let every job in America have a theme song.
Okay, Hedda. Let's see how that would work out musically, huh? Suppose you dream up a theme song for a fan dancer.
Well, I can dream it up, my dear, but if I sing it, it'll be a nightmare.
Now, don't you be so modest, Hedda. When you sing, it sounds like an angel.
Crosby, you're heading in the wrong direction. When I sing, it sounds like...
Hedda, okay, now, Hedda, you say that every occupation should have a theme song. So give us a theme song for the fan dancer.
Well, now let me see. A theme song for the fan dancer. Oh, how about this?
Huh?
Every little movement has a meaning all its own. Now, Bob, let's take a very important man who doesn't get half the credit he deserves. The garbage collector. Huh? Give us a theme song about him.
A theme song for the garbage collector? Wait a minute now. How's this? Everything I have is yours. I'll take all of it. Say, Hedda, how's about you cooking up a theme song for a lawyer?
One theme song for the lawyer coming right up. I'll be suing you in all your familiar places. I must ask Lum and Abner if they can use a girl singer.
Yeah.
Don't answer that question. Mr. Crosby, here's an occupation that's not exactly a proud one, but how about a theme song for the pickpocket?
Well, here's a tune I think would make an ideal theme song for the pickpocket. There's just one place for me near you. Say, Hedda, last but not least, could you give us a theme song for a dentist?
Over there, send the word over there.
Now, just a minute, Hedda, just a minute. How can over there be a theme song for the dentist?
Because the Yanks are coming.
Hedda Hopper and Bob Crosby. That last gag of yours will set corn back 500 years. Say, Bob, that terrific singing combo that backed you up in You Were Only Foolin', I hope they didn't do a Fate-a-Rooney.
Fate-a-Rooney?
You'll care for that? Mm-hmm. You see them anywhere in the crowd?
Well, when? They're right over there yonder. They're over there ogling the punch bowl.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yes, I wonder how they came to look so sad.
Probably just discovered that the stuff in the punch bowl is punch. Hey, Martinez, come on out here for a minute to the mic, will you?
Yeah, give out with one of those Club 15 dillies you're famous for. Felix Mills, help him give, will you, boy?
Love somebody, yes, I do. Love somebody, yes, I do. Love somebody, yes, I do. Love somebody, but I won't say who. Big and strong and bold and gay, he's not very far away. She would marry him today,
but who he is she will not say.
I love somebody, yes I do. Love somebody, yes I do. Love somebody, yes I do. Love somebody, but I won't say who.
Is it Al?
No, 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 no.
Is it John?
No, 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 no.
Well, is it Fran?
No, 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 no.
Well, it couldn't be Crosby. We give up.
Who is it?
Love somebody. Yes, I do. Love somebody. Really, I do. Oh, I still love my calla lilies, but there's someone else. Yes, I love somebody, but I won't say who.
Don't know why she acts so shy.
Now, really, baby, I'm a harmless guy.
Hope she doesn't pass me by.
Fall for one of you, I'd rather die.
Love somebody, yes, I do. Love somebody, yes, I do.
Love somebody, yes, I do.
She loves somebody, but she won't say who.
Gentlemen, if you've just now turned on your radio, you have a perfect right to know that a lot of show business folk have dropped into Lum and Abner's Jot'em Down store tonight and are throwing a surprise party in honor of the team's new half hour for Frigidaire over CBS next Sunday. Right here, I'd like to tell you the amazing story of how Lum and Abner got their first commercial radio show. Let's see. It was back... Point killer. Hello. Long distance? Say, how are you doing on that call to Bob Hope in New York?
He is?
Okay, we'll expect to hear from Hope within the next 10 minutes. Thanks. Hope's on the stage at a banquet accepting the Air Force's Association Award to Show Business for Overseas Entertainment During the War. We'll switch to New York and the moment Bob gets off. Now to get back to that story about Lum and Abner.
Wendell, stop the presses. Hopper has an exclusive.
Hedda, we've all seen your hat and we love it.
When I say exclusive, I mean newsflash. I just peeked out the front door, and guess who's ambling down the street heading for the Jot'em Down store? That character from the Red Skelton show, that loon goon with mental rigor mortis, Clem Kiddledoodle Hopper.
No, wait, no. No relation, no. Let's make it a surprise party for Clem, too. Now, quiet, everybody. Shh. Quick, turn out the lights. There. It's pitch black.
Well, here it is. Who's the doodle-oodle hopper? That's what I want to know. What a boy.
I see about 4F.
I'd like to punch the guy in the nose that told me that was funny.
Yes, sir, time sure flies. Here it is Sunday, and it seemed like only yesterday it was Saturday. Heck yeah, but I love Sunday. Nobody works, and I don't look so conspicuous that way. Well, here's where Lum and Abner's surprise party's going to be. I hope it ain't one of them We Are affairs. I was out last night after 2. Of course, I didn't catch even one. That's funny. There ain't no lights on in there. I wonder if Lum and Abner, in there in the dark, secretly listening to Amos and Andy. Oh, sure. Well, I better knock. It ain't healthy for prowlers around these parts. They shoot and then ask questions. Of course, they don't get many answers, but that's... I'll just tiptoe over and I'll tell you in just a minute. Hold on. This white part is that black stuff. I'll just tiptoe over so I don't disturb them if they're asleep in there. It's a good thing I ain't wearing shoes. Oh, there's an open window. I'll just peek in. Well, what do you know? They washed it. I wish I could see the end of my nose. I'll bet it's bleeding. Well, there's anybody home? Now, I know either Lum or Abner's at home by the looks of that clothesline. Either that or they've each got two suits of underwear. Oh, my. I'll just crawl through the window here. Oop. Stepped on my ear and ripped it.
It's dark in here. I can't see where I'm going. Oop.
Well, a fine place to leave the piano.
Somebody turn on the lights. Oop. Young man?
Yes?
What do you think you're doing?
Well, at the present, I'm breaking my leg. Howdy doody.
And to youdy tooty.
Well, you ain't written that way, believe me.
Were you invited to the Lum and Abner surprise party?
No, Red Skelton just asked me to bring one of his cameras over so he could take pictures of the party.
Oh, he did he? Mm-hmm. Say, haven't I seen you somewhere before?
Oh, I don't know. Shot much pool lately?
Tell you, you were an idiot.
Well, why should they? After all, I'm just an apprentice moron.
Say, what's your name, young man?
Well,
I'd like to know so I won't forget myself and mention in my column that you were at the Lum and Abner party.
Well, look, you do. Don't mention it the way you did while ago, please. You said a column?
Really? You look... Yes, I'm a newspaper woman.
Don't read my lines. It won't mean a thing, you know. You say you're a newspaper woman? Well, looks like skin to me. That's too bad for her. She didn't get it.
Is this a broadcasting studio or the Corn Exchange?
$10. You show me where it says that. Anyway. I didn't catch your name.
I didn't throw it. It's Hedda Hopper.
No. Not the Hedda Hopper. I never miss your column.
Oh, really?
Oh,
you never miss it?
No. I can't read. That's why I can't miss it.
Didn't you ever go to school?
Yeah, I went to school, yes.
Well, what did you take up?
Space. Well, I'll just leave the camera here and be on my way.
Clem, tell me before you go, where did you get that quaint hat you're wearing?
Yeah.
You know, I just love hats that are different.
You said it. That looks like two chickens fighting in a plate of spaghetti, don't it? I ain't wearing a hat.
Well, what's that on your head?
I don't... Well, what do you know? My pet skunk didn't run away after all. Well, good night, everybody.
Thank you. Our thanks to Red Skelton. Folks, back in the days when commercial radio was cutting its baby teeth, Lum and Abner were just old enough to vote. And here's that amazing story of how Lum and Abner landed their first commercial radio show.
Hi there, Wendell.
As I was saying, here's that amazing first lady of Club 15, Margaret Whiting.
Pardon me, Wendell. I want to ask Felix Mills something. Oh, Felix.
Yes, Margaret.
Did Bob Crosby give you a big manila envelope?
Yes, he did.
Oh, good. My orchestration of Tree in the Meadow is supposed to be in there.
I'll open it up, Maggie. Uh-oh.
Well, what's wrong, Felix? What's in the envelope?
A little pamphlet entitled How to Save Money. Eat nothing but Campbell's soup and never bet on Brother Bing's horses.
Maggie, don't worry about the orchestration. Just ad-lib it. Folks, one of America's number one tunes and one of America's number one gal singers.
A tree in the meadow with a stream drifting by, and carved upon that tree I see love you till I die. I shall always remember the love in your eye. The day you climbed upon that tree, I love you till I die. But further
Margaret Whiting, folks. Say, Margaret Whiting, wait a minute. Hold it, Maggie. Don't run off.
Well, I sang my song when I thought now I'm supposed to melt back and trot.
No, honey. You're like the basement light. You're still on. It's a joke. You see, we have one of the world's great singers here tonight, and you're going to do a duet with him.
Me? Sing a duet with one of the world's greatest singers? Well, gee, Wen, who is it?
I'll give you three guesses.
Lawrence Malkier?
No.
Inga Pinta?
No.
Carmen Lombardo?
No, honey, it's the old pepper pot himself, Bob Crosby.
Hiya, Mag. Say, what do you say we go dancing in the dark, huh?
Hold me close, Robert.
Watch your grammar, kid.
Okay, Robert, if you won't hold me close, hold me closely. Dancing in the dark till the tune ends. We're dancing in the dark and it soon ends.
We're waltzing in the wonder of why we're here. Time hurries by, we're here and then we're gone.
Looking for the light of a new love to brighten up the night. I have you, love,
and we can face the music together. This heart of mine, make yours part of mine, dear one. Tell me that we're one.
Dancing in the dark till the tune ends. We're dancing in the dark and it's soon.
We're waltzing in the wonder of why we're here. Time hurries by, we're here, and then we're gone.
Looking for the light of a new love to brighten up the night. I have you, love,
and we can face the music together. Dancing in the dark.
Jot 'em down store, Niles speaking. Oh, yes, operator. Well, you've got New York on the line? Bob Hope just got off the stage at the Air Force Association banquet, and he's coming to the phone. Hello. Hello, Bob. All set, Bob? Great. Ladies and gentlemen, our Lum and Abner surprise party switches to New York and Bob Hope.
How do you do? This is Bob, stockholder in the Cleveland Indians, and am I happy tonight, Hope, greeting you from the home of the second place club in the American League, New York. You know, I happened to be in Central Park this morning. It's so difficult to get a room. And I ran into the native sons and daughter of Pine Ridge, Arkansas, now living in New York, Picnic. Both members were there. And they said, tell Lum and Abner thanks and wish him good luck when the Jot 'em Down store goes on the air for Frigidaire next Sunday. Millions of us Americans feel the same way about Lum and Abner. In my case, the feeling goes back some 17 years, 1931 to be exact. In 1931, I was in vaudeville. That was the year of the big tomato crop. One night after my act, I went back to my one-room suite at the Chicago Y, turned on my two-tubed Atwater Kent, and caught Lum and Abner in their first commercial broadcast for Quaker Oats. Well, I was so excited, I almost dropped my earphones. But since 1931, Lum and Abner have done probably 3,000 air shows, and I swear I haven't missed a one. I admit I tuned in late a couple of times, but I always made it up the next time by tuning in early. In other words, I'm a loyal fan of the radio team that has a wonderful record of loyalty to the radio public. And there's a lot of other fellas feel the same way, and one of them is Jerry Colonna, who's right here with me. You remember Lum and Abner, Jerry?
Oh, sure. What do they do?
Well, they run a general store. They sell things.
Over or under the counter?
Well, it all depends on their hooper, but they're real nice fellas, and they operate out of a little town in Arkansas.
Little town? What's the name of the town?
Pine Ridge, Arkansas.
Pine Ridge, Arkansas?
Mm-hmm.
Well, we all got to go sometime.
Mm-hmm. I guess. Well, anyway, next Sunday night, when Lum and Abner start their new show, I'll have my nose pressed up against the window of the Jot 'em Down store. And while I'm looking in, you'll be listening in to Radio's All-Americans, Lum and Abner. Good luck, boys. So long, folks.
From the Jot 'em Down store, a transcontinental thank you to Bob Hope in New York. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we come to our guests of honor, the two fellows who are the reason we're all here tonight. For over 17 years, these two lovable old fellows have been making daily visits to your home. And during that time, they've established themselves pretty firmly in the hearts of the American public. With their whimsical humor, their down-to-earth philosophy, and their warmth of personality, they've carved themselves a unique place in radio.
Hi, Dogas, there's two fellas I'd love to meet.
Well, we were talking about you.
Aw.
Ladies and gentlemen, here they are, Lum and Abner.
Well, Dogas, Lum, don't just stand there, say something.
Having a little trouble with a lump in my throat right now, Abner.
Well.
You know, this really ain't no surprise, folks, because we knowed about it all the time. But the way I feel right now, it might just as well have been a surprise. I don't know. It just sort of does something to you inside when you see these folks in radio that's busy with their own shows take the time to come down here tonight to welcome me and Abner to our new show. We're sort of branching out here now, you know. We're a little nervous about it.
Oh.
You don't know what it means to get a send-off like this from our old friends.
I'll amen that.
Me and Abner feels... Well, grannies, I don't think there's any words that says what we do feel right now, but I, grannies, with all the encouragement you folks have given us, we sure ain't gonna let you down. Thanks, folks. Thanks.
Thanks for listening. This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.